Hi, everybody. I'm Mike with Lenovo, and I'm here with the ThinkCenter M73 series, which is available in three form factors. We have a tower, the small, and the tiny. Today, we're going to be replacing the optical drive in the small form factor. The process will take about 10 minutes, and it should be easy enough for anyone to do. The only tool required is going to be a Phillips screwdriver. Before we continue, we want to make sure that we're protected against electrostatic discharge, or ESD. For more information on ESD, click the link in the description. Now let's get started. First, you want to remove the two thumb screws. And then slide the cover back and lift it. Now we want to pop the clips loose on the front bezel and then open it and remove it. And we still have a cable here that goes inside. And now we need to open the drive bay assembly. We just want to open it until this latch pops and locks it open. Now we need to disconnect the power button cable from the system board. And now we have these two clips that hold the cable in place. You twist to open the clips, and then you can pull the cable out. So now we just need to pull the front bezel away from the system and feed this cable through the hole in the chassis. And now we need to lay the system down flat on the table. Now we want to disconnect the optical drive cables. And now we have to remove two screws from the side of the optical drive. And then we press inward on the latch and lower the drive bay assembly down. Push from behind and pull the drive out of the front of the system. Now we're going to take our new optical drive and put it in the system. So we slide the optical drive into the drive bay assembly through the front of the system. And then we open the drive bay assembly. Then we install the two screws into the side to hold the drive into place. And now we reconnect the cables to the optical drive. So now we need to stand the system back up to put the front bezel back on. We need to feed the power button cable through the hole in the chassis and pull it all the way through. Now we gotta make sure the cable goes back into the clips and you twist the clip to close it. Now we need to reconnect the power button cable to the system board. Now we need to close the drive bay assembly. We want to press down on the blue touch point on that latch, which allows you to close it. And then you just make sure it closes all the way. And now we want to align the hinge clips with the holes in the chassis and then close the front bezel like a door. We place the cover onto the system and slide it forward, then replace the two thumb screws.